when a woman has a child, I think that she is forced to be a little bit more mature, a little bit more grown up, a little more thinking about what life is going to be for her and her child. It's not just her. That might be a little bit better for some people, that she is really looking for a serious man, someone that's going to be able to take care of not just her, but her child as well. It used to be that the United States required that the father give permanent permission for the child to come over. And from my understanding, that they don't do that any longer, but I think it's really, really important that you actually get the permission from the father if the father's still in the picture. Now, sometimes the father has not been in the picture since birth. And if that's the case, then she just needs to document that. But if the father is involved, let's say the father's even giving child support, which unfortunately doesn't happen very often, but if that's the case, then you're gonna have to deal with that father just like you would if you were gonna marry someone in California and move to New York. But I can tell you, in all the years I've been doing this, usually isn't that much of a problem, because unfortunately, the father's just usually not involved in the picture. So, and the mother, when she joins the service, knows that ultimately she may be moving. If she has a child, the child will attach to the mother's K-1 as a K-2, right? It's called a K-2 visa, but it mirrors the mother's K-1 visa. So everything that the mother's going through, the child will automatically go through. You just fill out an extra form for it and that's it. So it's really not complicated, and the child will just come over with the mother, and everything that happens to the mother happens to the child simultaneously. K-1, K-2 visa, easy, easy, easy. As the child gets older, especially in the teenage years, it can be more difficult, not always. I've seen some that worked really well, and I've seen some where it hasn't. And part of that is because, you know, almost always, it's because the man and the woman are not on the same page as how they're gonna raise the child, especially when the child's older. Because the child obviously knows that you're not the biological father, and if the mother is not totally behind you, you have a united front when there's discipline to be done, then you can easily have like two against one, and you'd become the one as the father. Is not good. So that's really, really important, to talk to your fiance or talk to the woman you're very interested in about how she parents, you know, and make sure that you're both on the same page about how you would discipline the child, how you would bring up the child, so that when you get here, if the child wants to stay up till 2 a.m. playing video games when he's 14, instead of going to school, then that's not okay, then you're both saying it's not okay. Because I know one case where the father, the stepfather basically, was saying, no, that's not okay, you need to go to school. And the mother said, oh no, it's okay, you can stay up till 3 a.m. playing video games. And that did not go well. That marriage ended up in a divorce, because they were not on the same page when it came to parenting and what was important. I mean, that parent would let the child stay home and play video games instead of go to school. See, I couldn't do that. I wouldn't. That to me is not good parenting, and to that father it wasn't good parenting, and that caused problems. I think excluding women with children is a mistake. It's the right woman for you and she has a child, but then, you know, that may just be a blessing down the road. I know it was for me.